And good evening, I'm Paul Folger. This is Nightcast. We start with a story about two parents who want to make sure no one else has to go through what they have the past 2 years. Archer Amorosi was shot and killed by Carver County deputies in July of 2018 during what appeared to be a mental health crisis. His parents tell us their lives were turned upside down and Archer's reputation was destroyed. They sued Carver County, claiming the release of their son's name violated state privacy laws for minors. And today, they settled with the county for $450,000. And they sat down with R.J. Coles. It's a story you're seeing first on 5.
The true character of 16-year-old Archer Amorosi was lost among half-truths, innuendo, and flat-out wrong information. That's according to the claims laid out in this lawsuit against Carver County by Don and Kara Amorosi, Archer's parents. It says Archer's right to privacy was violated under the law because they say he was a minor.
They shouldn't be allowed to release information that's private just for sensationalism. That's disgusting and it's wrong.
It was July 2018 when Carver County deputies responded to a disturbance call at the Amorosi's home in Chanhassen. Investigators say an agitated Archer ran toward deputies with a weapon, refused to comply with officers, and was shot multiple times. Details about his death and his mental health issues were shared publicly by Carver County Attorney Mark Metz against the wishes of Archer's family because he was only a teen.
What was that like for you to sit in that room and be told, no, we are going to release it? How was that for you?
I had never seen anyone around me in my life treat this tragedy with such insensitivity.
Metz released a lengthy report explaining why there were no charges against the deputies. The Amorosis say they didn't get to see that ahead of time. And the fact Archer was identified and then his death described in great detail was simply, they say, a burden unbearable.
It was horrific. And I remember sitting there at this computer sobbing because these statements were not true.
The 34-page report that he released had information in it that personally, I would have never wanted to know in my entire life. Had I had the choice not to know it, I would have chosen not to. But I had no choice. I stumbled on it as I read it. The press was calling me about this 34-page report I hadn't even read yet.
The Amorosis claimed Archer's personal life and struggles were now laid out for the whole world, including Minnetonka High School friends. His parents say none of his personal issues should have been made public because he was a minor.
He was just everything funny. And did he have some mental health issues? Yeah, he did have some struggles, but it was a small part of him. And Archer was an amazing person.
His family now has a nonprofit called Archer's Aim. It's there to help other children who might have mental health challenges. And even in his death, his parents say his generosity and kindness live on.
I knew that he was everything to me, but I didn't know the impact he had on others.
I miss him like crazy.
Now, the law firm representing the county issued a statement that says, in part, quote, there is no admission of liability or wrongdoing with respect to the county's release of data related to the incident. County Attorney Mark Metz and Sheriff Jason Kamrud were separately and voluntarily dismissed for the payment of $0. The county maintains the data that was released is public information, but also recognizes this is a cost-effective resolution which brings closure to this matter. Paul?
Jay, I'm glad his parents sat down with you and spent some time today. Yep. I also spent some time today reading some state statutes and how they got to this settlement. Mm-hmm. And really, this case has nothing to do with officers' actions that day. This is about privacy.
A clear distinction, Paul. Yes, this is about the violation of the Data Practices Act. That's what the allegations were. This was not related to the conduct of the officers and the events leading up to it. This was simply a privacy matter. He is a minor. When charges are usually brought against minors, unless they're charged as an adult, their names are usually kept private. And usually in charging documents, you will see their initials rather than their names, Paul.
Yeah, exactly. Okay, Jay Coles, thank you. Mm-hmm.